سبحانه وتعالى دين سيس وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. Allah says that he is kursi, translated as a footstool or a chair or footstool. This kursi, this kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it encompasses the heavens and the earth. And subhanallah, in a hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that there are seven heavens and seven earths. And the distance between each heaven is a distance of 500 years. So between heaven 1 and 2, the distance of 500 years. Until we get to the heaven between 6 and 7, the distance of 500 years. Above the seventh heaven, above the seventh heaven comes the kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now the seven heavens and the seven earths all put together in front of this kursi of Allah, in front of this kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like a ring in a massive, large, huge desert. Subhanallah. Above this kursi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses every single thing. Now the seven heavens and the seven earths and the kursi of Allah, all of them put together in front of the arch of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like a ring in a desert. Subhanallah. Loftier than this maqam, higher than this maqam, greater than this position, is the position of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How magnificent is Allah! How powerful is Allah! How great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala! How high and how lofty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is! And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يَعُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَلَا يَعُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that to guard these heavens and these earths, they do not exhaust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Guarding them does not tire out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't exhaust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know what that really means? Guarding the heaven, guarding the earth, guarding the sun, guarding the moon, guarding humankind, guarding jinnkind, guarding the animals, guarding the birds in the sky, guarding the fish in the ocean, guarding that little bird that left its nest, guarding the egg that is still in the nest. Subhanallah. Allah says all of these things do not tire him. وَلَا يَعُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. And you know, in human experience, guarding, with it comes exhaustion. And we have a guard that's guarding a place. If we don't have shaf, then he become tired. If he stands there all day, all night, he become tired. If he doesn't march from one place to another place, he'll become tired. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but Allah, fi haqqi Allahi azza wa jal, guarding the heavens and the earth, do not exhaust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the least. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa huwa al-aliyyu al-azim. And He is the high, He is the lofty, He is the azim, the supreme being, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Really, my dear brothers and elders in Islam, how interesting is this verse, ayatul kursi, known as the grand chief ayah of all the ayahs of the Quran.